What's up, guys? In this tutorial, I will show you how to fix the issue when your or a contact's number is not showing up anymore in iMessage or FaceTime. This should be quite an easy tutorial. For more information, click on the first link in the description below. In most cases, this problem is caused by an option which prevents you from getting contacted by iMessage or FaceTime. Open up your iPhone settings. Here, scroll down and tap on Messages. Make sure that the iMessage option is enabled. It may take a couple of seconds to activate this option. When this is done, select Send and Receive. Here, under You can receive messages and reply from, make sure that Primary is selected, as well as your number and Apple ID. You will have to sign in with your Apple ID to complete this step. When this is done, head back to your main settings and select FaceTime. Under You can be reached by FaceTime at, make sure that your phone number and Apple ID are selected. This should in most cases enable you to be contacted by your phone number or Apple ID address for FaceTime or iMessage. In case this did not help you out, then this issue is most likely related to your iOS version, Apple ID account, or network connection. In order to use FaceTime, you have to ensure a stable network connection. You can use speed testing sites or applications such as SpeedTest to make sure that this problem is not caused by your current connection. Open up your settings application. Here, tap on your Apple ID and select to sign out, and after a few seconds, proceed to sign back into your account. This will ensure that the correct Apple ID can be contacted and that you have permissions on your device to make changes to your Apple ID settings. Lastly, in your general settings, tap on Software Update. Here, select to download and install the latest update, in case there's one available to you. You can then proceed to restart your iPhone. Restarting your device will restart all processes, which can, in a lot of cases, fix these kinds of problems. In case you have any further issues or problems following this tutorial, then I suggest following my extensive guide linked in the description below. I hope this helped you out. Leave a comment if you have any questions, and see you in the next one.